Gotta get some reps in. Oh yeah, feel the burn. Oh yeah. Welcome back to yet another episode of So You're Interested In, the show where I break down an artist's discography in order to give you, the viewer, the best possible jumping off point in order to get into their catalog. And in this video, we will be breaking down the elusive discography of neo-psychedelic rockers, The Flaming Lips. Originating in Oklahoma City, Oklahoma, this alt-rock crew have definitely been around the block once or twice. Their legacy lies in their ability to adapt, overcome, and evolve their way through the music industry by putting out some of the most poignant and, albeit strange, records of the past few decades. Even in the past year, with COVID raging on, the group still found a way to entertain the masses by performing a concert in giant bubbles. Yes, they are crazy, but it is because of this craziness that they are so beloved by so many different people. They have released a lot of music throughout their never-ending tenure, so I'm going to suggest two albums and three individual tracks that I think you should check out in order to dip your toes into this broad discography. Don't be scared, we're starting off the albums. The first Flaming Lips album to listen to is their 2002 release, Yoshimi Battles the Pink Robots. Arguably one of the finest neo-psych concept albums, the band successfully merges abstract soundscapes with conventional songwriting, morphing into what I once saw described as complicated, easy listening. I've gotta agree with that description, though of course, Yoshimi Battles the Pink Robots is much more than one phrase boils it down to be. Starting with Fight Test, the album slips you in nicely to the warm sci-fi atmosphere. Wayne Coyne's soothing vocals swell into the mesmerizing mix of blips and bleeps that are stretched out to sound like a bass playing underwater. Next, In the Morning of the Magicians is a light trip that will melt your brain, not because of the instrumental, but instead because of the heavy lyrics. Though this is not a knock on the instrumental, as I personally find this to be one of the album's best, as it constantly finds new ways to evolve without ever changing the song's direction. Last but certainly not least, you need to listen to the simultaneously heartbreaking and empowering Do You Realize? Simply put, the cinematic feelings that the song evokes are beyond the powers of even the most sappy coming-of-age films. Coyne's lyrics address the fact that everybody that we know will eventually die, but instead of being sad about this, we need to make the most of our time and not get caught up in the minutiae of everyday life. Yoshimi Battles the Pink Robots is easily one of the most recognizable albums of all time, full of impeccable songs, making it a required listen for any incoming Flaming Lips fans. Next up, be sure to check out their 1999 record, The Soft Bulletin. The word eclectic gets tossed around a lot, but if there's one album that truly embodies the definition of that word, it's The Soft Bulletin. Now, there is much debate about the true track list of this album, so for the record, I've only listened to the Spotify version as I do not own any of the physical copies yet. Regardless, the first song to check out is my personal favorite, Race for the Prize. The production on this track alone should make it a must listen, with the rattling drum slaps and soaring synths sounding utterly majestic. Oh, and the lyrics are unmatched. The Spiderbite song is up next. Coyne's vocal sounds stretched out, as the pulsating percussion in the background is only amplified by the drums inhaling and exhaling in the foreground. Finally, be sure to pay attention to Waiting for a Superman. The instrumental feels like it's slugging behind the drum beat, giving this track an interesting spin, while the vocal mixing gives Coyne's voice a slight bump above being whispered. The Soft Bulletin is an achievement in what can be accomplished in production, while also boasting some of the best songs in the Flaming Lips discography. Come along now, we're moving on to the tracks. The first track to check out from the Flaming Lips is their 1993 hit single, She Don't Use Jelly, from the album Transmissions from the Satellite Heart. Easily one of the most recognizable Flaming Lips tracks, this cut has everything, from melodic guitar licks to wacky lyrics. She Don't Use Jelly is a perfect intersection between the strange world of the Flaming Lips and conventional pop music. Coyne's lyrics and vocals are lighthearted, yet pointed to the touch, while the dynamics of the instrumentals range from nearly unheard and whispered to heavy and rambunctious. Truly one of the best that the Flaming Lips has to offer, be sure to hear She Don't Use Jelly. Next up, be sure to hear Christmas at the Zoo, which comes off their 1995 release, Clouds Taste Metallic. For the most part, many of the songs that I've talked about truly push the boundaries of neo-psych, alt-rock, and even noise rock. But Christmas at the Zoo will break that pattern, not because it isn't good or revolutionary, but because it effectively acts exactly how it should. It has everything you could want in a Flaming Lips song, from the quirky lyrics to the out-of-this-world sounds and Coyne's bubbly vocals. I also think that it'll be a defining track for new listeners, as it will really put you to the test to see how much nonsensical music you can handle. Regardless, go give it a listen. The last track you need to lend your ear to is Mother I've Taken LSD, which comes off their latest LP, American Head. Now listen, there are so many Flaming Lips songs to choose from. Seriously, this video took forever to write because there is so much to sift through. But for this last song, I decided to pick something more recent in order to better understand the state of the band today. Mother I've Taken LSD fits that description perfectly in my opinion. It is epic in every sense of the word, as the instrumental rises and falls to meet the exploding emotion in Coyne's voice. The vocals are lamentable, instrumenting, and the guitars, drums, and strings all illuminate that effectively. Mother I've Taken LSD accurately sums up the current state of the band today, so do be sure to listen to it. And that does it. That is my video on the Flaming Lips. Like I said already, there are so many albums and songs to choose from, so I definitely could have missed out one of your favorites. But in my humblest of opinions, I do think that the albums and tracks that I picked will help new listeners get into the band more easily. This is an intimidating discography from afar, so hopefully my video can help you out. And if it did, or if it didn't, be sure to let me know in the comment section below. Down there, you can also suggest any artist or band that you would like to see covered on this show. This video was actually suggested by one of my viewers, so yes, I do consider all of my recommendations. Be sure to subscribe for videos just like this every single Wednesday, along with the occasional one on Mondays. There's also Forever Spinning, which comes out on Friday, which is basically a video history essay on a classic album. So that does it. Be sure to listen to The Flaming Lips, wear a mask when you go outside, support your local record stores or local artists. I'm sure they could use all of the help that they could get right now, so if you have the money to do so, please help them out. All right, that does it. Until next time, happy listening.